Hey, good optometry morning. Dr. Michael Nelson, your YouTube eye doctor here, and today we are telling you what myopia is, and we are starting right now. Okay, and so myopia or nearsightedness is the most common refractive error or prescription that people will typically have. And it occurs when the refractive components of the eyeball, which include the cornea and the lens, don't focus images on the back of the retina, but rather they focus it in front of them. And it typically occurs when the axial length or the length of the eyeball is longer than it should be. And so there's a mismatch in the refractive part of the eye and the length of the eyeball, resulting in the image not being in focus on the retina. And so what it means if you're myopic is that you are not going to be able to see images clearly far away. And so no matter how hard you squint or strain your eyes or try to focus on things far away, you can't get it in focus. And that's why it's also referred to as nearsightedness, because it means that you can see things up close, but you can't see things far away. Okay, so you can tell if you're nearsighted just by looking at the numbers on your glasses prescription. So the numbers you want to look at are the first set of numbers, which is going to be under the column called sphere. And so what you want to look at is the sign in front of this number. And this is either going to be a plus sign or a minus sign. And if this sign is a minus sign, that means you're nearsighted. And now the higher that number is, the more nearsighted you are. And so we will typically categorize myopia in a few different categories. We will consider you to be a low myope if your prescription is under minus three. If your prescription is between minus three and minus six, you are considered a moderate myope. And if your prescription is over minus six, then you are considered highly myopic. So myopia will typically first occur in young children. And this is just one reason why you want to make sure kids have annual eye exams starting at least by the age of three. And so myopia will often increase during those critical preteen and teenage years. And so what we'll also notice is that the younger a child is when they first become myopic, the higher their prescription will be when they're an adult. Okay, so if you're myopic, you are not alone in the world. It's estimated that in 2010, about 28% of the world's population is myopic. And this number is going up. And if we don't intervene, it's predicted by the year 2050, about 50% of the world's population will be nearsighted. All right, so there's two things you need to do if you or your child is nearsighted. Number one, you should have glasses or contact lenses to put that image in focus on the retina so you can see things clearly far away. And number two, you want to make sure you talk to your optometrist about options that can help slow down the progression of your myopia. So we don't have any ways that can stop your myopia completely or to reverse it, but there are definitely options that can slow down the progression of it. And this whole area is called myopia management or myopia control. So you need to talk to your optometrist about that. And if you want to learn more about myopia, hit the subscribe button down below, or there's more videos here that you can watch about myopia. And with that, have a great optometry day.